turn the pan. Now, it was the Ayrshire tatties that I used for the roast today. And all you do, I've cooked one because they take a wee bit longer to prepare, is I grated its skin on. It's such a fine skin that's on an Ayrshire. And life's too short. It's not like your granny's tatties that you have to keep off, keep some up before you go to them. But I remember the day that I was down, was it on a Scotty Band farm that I went down to? Yes. And actually, you just shove your hands in the furrows and pull them up, and it was full of tatties, and it was such a good experience from me growing up, and it was one of my jobs was to turn the soil for the tatties for my granny, or to do, you know, all these kind of old school, I think, for getting back to how good we should be at cooking. It's got to start in a field with the kids, or eat yourself. You know, I was down on my hands and knees and getting to pull up all these fresh tatties, and it was maybe the first couple of days, they hadn't even started picking them, I don't think, at the time, so it was almost this big anticipation of, right, how are they, how do they look? And did we do the same with carrots? Was that the one up in Turriff?
Yeah.
And again, great experience. It really gets you back to where it all comes from. We walked up the field, shook the big beautiful carrot tops, and out come these amazing carrots that virtually just pull out of this gorgeous sandy soil that's in the East Coast. It was a brilliant experience. So these guys are there to make sure that feeling, you know, of when they pick them up to when we actually pick them up in the shops and cook with them, it's the same sort of thing. It's decided it was the time as well. Flip to implement instructions. So keeping the skin on them. Skin on, a tiny wee pinch of bicarb, take a teaspoon of flour and an egg yolk. I rinsed out the potato. It was quite a nice dry potato, so I didn't actually need to get too much of the water out of it. Bring it out, mix it up with the egg, bicarb, flour, and just pop it into the pan. If you want to make shapes out of it, then use a squad cutter and make sure that they're all nice and uniformed, but I'm sure you've all known me long enough to know that I'm not a straight edge kind of girl, so quite happy to be a wee bit rough around the edges. In the likes of the roasties, what we did is all the food came in this morning, and we prepared them and then just popped them in the fridge. So if you're going to do this for a sort of dinner party, you can do it the day before and then just pop them in the oven just to warm them through. The peas that you got were just Scotty Brand peas. Put in a blitzer with cumin seeds, smoked paprika and a bit of salt and pepper. And then through the blender, just a nice wee bit of warmth at the back of the sweetness. I've got a wee poached egg here already. Salmon, did you like that? It's a really nice flavour, wasn't it? And again, keeping it. Cooking should always be about using great produce and spending time with the people that you've brought over to enjoy it with you. And instead of you being in the kitchen constantly. Puree. Super easy to do. Chefs, you know, the joy of picking pea pods they never actually make it to the port. In my house, they always get eaten. So it's a bit of a long job if you want to have peas, where chefs always use frozen peas because they're frozen at their absolute best. And I've made a pea dip at the weekend, just trying different things with the peas and a handful of frozen peas, some yogurt, chili, garlic, and lime juice, coriander seed and cumin seed. What an amazing dip it was. And you would never normally, it's not really a, when you think about dips, something that would quickly spring to mind, but super tasty. Nice sweet peas to balance the whole thing out. The zest of a lemon over the top. A wee sprig of dill. Twist of black pepper. And that's the dish all ready.
How do you get poached eggs so beautiful?
We trim them, so poached eggs need to be cooked in a big pot, a big tall pot, and you drop them in so they go down the way, so that all the whites, the yolk goes to the bottom and the white goes behind it, so it's going down like a bullet. And then we lift them out after 90 seconds and we cut round the sides and trim off all the wee feathery bits, and then into iced water, and then we'll leave them 2 minutes to bring them back round, so they will never be in for 90 seconds when they're first cooked. Vortexes and so on in pans are fine if you're doing one poached egg. I've never done one poached egg in my life, even at home. You know, there's always, everybody wants to have poached eggs. Now the last one I'm going to bring you to, which you've not yet had, so it'll be quite nice for you to see how we're going to assemble it, is I don't mean to speak too much about these because they really are something special. Wasting nothing of them. Be very careful when you're trimming strawberries. A strawberry huller or a straw put through the bottom of the strawberry pokes the hull out, and when they're this ripe and ready, that stalk will come right through. The whole white stalk just pulls out the top. And normally, as I said to the girls when they first come in, I would normally sweeten strawberries to make a coulis, but I didn't need to because they're actually sweet enough. So what we want to put in the mixture is, it's just a Greek yogurt, so really nice creamy Greek yogurt. I've got some pistachio that we use, just a wee bit of earthiness in it, tiny tiny bit of Ed's honey today, Glasgow honey, great product. And we are using the honey in the dish, which is the other reason that I wouldn't want to put too much or any sweetness in. And probably the only time that I would actually chop these up, because they're just too good to, when they're this size and they're this great quality, you don't want to not see them. You want to actually see every piece of fruit, which is why I slice it that way at the bottom of the glass so you can actually see it. Chopped up and stir it and nonsense. That's just a natural Greek, and then great local honey. And you should always be proud to serve the fruits. You know, the stalks are absolutely in great condition, and a wee bit of shortbread at the side of it. There's 3 or 4 Scotty brand products on this table that have just produced you know, a three-course fantastic lunch. You sew everything from start to finish. I don't think it gets much simpler than this. I don't think you get much better produce than this. So I think let everybody know out there how good it is to support Scotty brand for the summer season coming in.